So the related party concept is met in the exception that we already saw. So over here, right? Related person, 85%, right? So if you have that 85% threshold, right, and it's sold to a related person, then you are not allowed to use the transaction value method, you have to use net cost method. So the next question is obviously, what does it mean to be a related person? And here's what it means. A related person is defined as a person related to another person on the basis of, so here we're in a corporate world, right? So this is the business party relationship. We have officer director, we have legally recognized partners, employee-employee, employer-employee relationships, and take a note here, person directly or indirectly owns or controls or holds 25% or more of the outstanding voting stock. The 25% rule is very interesting because we already saw the related party definition in our discussion under the appraised value of merchandise. Specifically, we're talking about section 152.102. So 152.02 is a general section that deals with valuation and appraisement of merchandise. And let's check out the definition that is provided for related persons in there. All right, so paragraph G. Paragraph G defines related person to be any person directly or indirectly owning and controlling or holding a power to vote 5% or more of the outstanding voting shares. So if you have 5% of the property, of the corporate stock, of the shareholding power, 5% or more is good enough for you to qualify as related. But that's under the transaction value, right? So related person is not to be confused with so section 181 so part 181 appendix 2 so part so NAFTA related person, let's make it easier, is 25% threshold, 25%, but regular transaction the section, the regular transaction value, the let's call it a general valuation, all right? General valuation. It is 5%. And we're talking about here, section 152.102. That's my 5. All right. So here, this 5% rule is not to be confused with the 25% rule under NAFTA. And guess what? Customs examiners, whenever they provide you with the question, that 25% question, they will kind of test you on your intellectual bias in favor of 152.102 versus NAFTA. So, John Smith of California and his brother-in-law Rob Doe of Mexico are co-owners of Importal Incorporated and have been involved in a successful NAFTA import and export business partnership for several years. John of California claims NAFTA duty-free treatment on his importations. Which of the following statements is not a true statement under NAFTA, a related party person, means so you have legally recognized partners So that's good. Employee-employee relationship, that's good. Officers having ownership in one another, in one another's enterprise, that's good. Any person directly or indirectly owning, controlling, or holding 5% or more of the outstanding voting stock. So here, examiners are alluding to your intellectual bias under the valuation of merchandise, where you trying to understand is the transaction value appropriate basis, because transaction value must be done at arm's length, right? Meaning that there is no relationship. But the relationship criteria under the transaction value, for transaction value purposes, is 5%. For NAFTA, it is 25%. So here examiners are alluding to that 5% rule, which deals with the transaction value in general, not with the NAFTA regional value content calculations. So here 5% makes it a not true statement, because it deals with a totally different concept under customs law, making D a correct answer choice. So what about the relationship? We know they are brothers-in-law, right? Will that affect? So besides the business relationship, we have a blood relationship, right? So let's take a look. Persons are members of the same family, either natural or adopted children, brothers, sisters, parents, grandparents, spouses. All right, so brother is good enough, but brother-in-law is not good enough, because there is no that blood, that or that blood relationship is too far-fetched. So brother-in-law, the blood relationship will not do. So here, would be the true statement, right? But here, under NAFTA, a related person means, notice, and this is also a tricky part, because notice, even though they describe this, right, they are members of the same family, implying it's a true statement, right? Okay, it's a false statement, because it has to be a brother, not a brother-in-law. But customs examiners, then the next thing, they turn around and say, under NAFTA, a related person means person is related to another person on the basis. So they are like moving away from this fact pattern, which is there to confuse you, and they are testing you on the general definition of related persons under NAFTA. So this is where this tricky part comes in, because all right, you are thinking this, but it's not. It would not be true statement, and you are likely to pick this one, because brother-in-law is not the same as brother. But at the same time, this one, the school of the question, is not the relationship between Rob and John. It is the general definition of the related parties under the NAFTA, under North American Free Trade Agreement rules. So this is why it's very important for us to go through this analytical perspective points, because we can easily be fooled or get carried away with something which is not really being asked. So D is the correct answer choice for this one.